Hello everyone, my name is Paulo Alves, and on this video we're going to create the home screen of our Real Delivery app using the React Native. Subscribe to the channel if you want to follow this development, and let's go to the code. This is the screen that the user will see right after the user logs in or registers in the application using the screens that we developed before. In this screen, we are going to use the Maps library, and the screen will have three different possible states. The first state is this one, when the user enters the screen, so I'm going to show to the user its location and some delivery persons around that location. The second state is going to be right after the user selects the origin and destination of that delivery. So the user will see a summary about that delivery with the price and a cancel and confirmation button. And the third state will be a screen showing that we are searching for a delivery person. So that's what we are going to build today. First, I will create the folder home within the app/screens folder. This folder will contain the code of our new screen. Now let's create the file that's going to be called home.screen.tsx. This file will contain the code of our page. Let's get started importing the React library, which we always have to do in our TSX files. I'm going to create a constant called homescreen. This constant is a function, and this function will initially return a safe area view. Inside of this safe area view, I'm going to put a title with the text homescreen. Now I will export the home screen so we can use it in other files. And I'll go to the app.tsx file and I'll use the home screen. Now we'll be able to see in our emulator that the home screen is showing. Remember that my goal here at this point is just to create the pages. So I removed the login screen and I put the home screen. Okay, let's go back to our home screen file. You can see in the emulator that what I have to do now is to add the map to that screen. To know how to do this, I'll go to the React Native Maps package page and I'll follow the installation instructions that we have here. First, we have to install the React Native Maps package. So let's open a new command line to do this. I'm going to type npm install React Native Maps. In addition to that, we'll have to add more settings to make the map work in our app. First, we'll go to the AndroidManifest.xml file, and within the application tag, we will have to add a new tag containing the Google Maps key. To get that key, you have to go to the Google Cloud Console platform, enter the APIs and Services menu, and add the new credential. Let's go back to the React Native Maps page. Let's go to the Android Manifest file, and then I will copy this code and paste the key within the application. I replace this part with the Google Maps API key that I have. I will indent the code to make it more readable and save it. Now, the last step we have to do is to call the React Native link React Native Maps. This command executes all these other settings that exist on the React Native Maps page. Now let's go back to our code. I'm going to remove that title component. I will inform that this safe area view is going to have a flex style because it will occupy the entire screen. And now I will add our map view component. I'll inform also that it has a flex style, so it will also occupy the entire screen. I'll save it and let's take a look at the emulator. We can see that the map is opening at the latitude and longitude 0. I mean, it's opening in the middle of the planet. I'm going to inform that the initial region of our map is going to be my current latitude and longitude. This delta latitude and delta longitude are necessary for the map to make some calculations to zoom our map. I do not understand this calculation very well. I just took these values of 0.09 and 0.04 from a code example that I found, and it worked pretty well. We already have our map being shown on the screen for the region that I am right now. So now let's create our home.style.tsx file. Inside of it, I'll export the constant home_style, and this constant will receive a style sheet that will be created with the following properties. For now, we only have one property that will be flex, and this property will have a value of 1. I'm doing this so I can go back to the component file and replace this style. As I said in one of the previous videos, I think that putting the page and the styles in the same file is a bad practice. Now, let's set up the first state of our screen. This state will only have a floating button added to the bottom right part of the page. The React Native paper has a component called Fab. We can see on its page an example of how to use this floating action button. This is the component that I need, so let's add this component to our screen. To do that, I use the fab component, and I'll inform that it will have a plus icon. Let's save it and see how it looks on the screen. We can see it looks a bit terrible, but this is because we haven't added the style of that component. So let's go to our style file. I'm going to add a new property called fab. I will say that it has the position absolute, that the right side of it will be 0, and that the bottom side of it is going to be 0 also. Now I need to come here to our screen and add that style to our fab button. I'll save the two files and we'll be able to see in our app that it looks much better now, but it's still bad because it's very close to the edges of the application. To fix this, we can simply add a margin. I'm going to add 16 and let's see how it looks now. What I also want here is that the first screen shows the positions of the delivery persons who are nearby me. So let's add a marker to the map. To do this, I have to open the map view as the markers stay inside of it. And I'm going to add the marker component. This component will have the description equal to delivery person 1. And I'll inform also that its coordinate will be equal to an object that contains the latitude of -3723 and the longitude of -38515. You can see that I added the marker near the initial location that I defined here on the map. I'm going to close this component and let's see how it looks on the screen. Okay, it's using a standard Google marker, so let's add a marker that looks better. To do this, I'll create a folder called assets, which will have some image files and icons and everything else. I'm going to paste a marker that I already have copied, which is a bicycle marker. So now let's add this icon to our marker. To do this, I have to open the marker component as the image will stay inside of it, and then I can add our image. And now I'm going to add the image component, and its image will have a source. To be able to add this icon, I'll have to add a require and look for the icon. Now I'll close this tag and let's see how it looks in our application. I think it looks kind of big, right? So what we are going to do now is on our home style, create another style for that icon. I'll put a marker image. It will have a width of 35 and its height also as 35. I'll save it and let's go to the image and reference that style by adding the property that we just created. We can now go to the map and see that it looks much better now. What we are going to do now is to add two more markers just so we have a more visually filled map and it becomes cooler. Let's go back to the code, and what I'm going to do now is to copy and paste this part twice and slightly change the latitude and longitude. I'll save it and we'll see all the icons now. Okay, this is state 1 of our screen showing to the logged user the delivery persons who are nearby. Now for the second state of our home screen, which is when the user selected the origin and the destination of its delivery. I mean, after clicking on this plus button, then the user is redirected to a screen where it can add delivery points, and now the user will see a summary of its delivery with the value of the delivery, and then the user will be able to accept or cancel that delivery. As we are doing all of this on the same screen, let's start by creating up here a constant that is going to be called state, and it will have the value of 1 for now. Now we will make a change on the code because I just need to show these three markers when my status is 1. So I'm going to create this condition in the code. I'll open these braces and ask if the state is equal to 1. In case it is equal to 1, I'll add the markers. And if the status is not equal to 1, I'll return null. Notice that our code is showing an error because this kind of code structure on React has to return only one component. But in this case here, I'm returning three components. So let's create an empty component just to help me with this. And I'm going to close it down here. And now the code no longer shows us an error. And if I save it, everything will be the same way as before. I also have to do that same thing for our button because it only shows up on state number 1. So I'm going to create a ternary here asking if the state is 1. If the state is 1, I will show the button, okay, this is what I needed for the state. Let's change the state to number 2, and that will give us an error because I have to inform that this is a number. as it was being considered of the type 2, but the type is a number. After I save this, our markers and our button no longer appear. Okay, what I want to show here in this state number 2 is a card with the summary of the delivery. To do that, we are going to use the card component again. So I'll just create a ternary here asking if the state is equal to 2. If the state is 2, I will add the card component. If not, I will just return null. This card will have a content, and inside of that content, I'm going to use a list.item component. It will have a title that is the price of that delivery. I'll put here 15 monies, and I will also add the description of it, which will be the total delivery price. Now I'm going to close the tag, let's save it, and let's see how it looks. Okay, now I think the icon of the bike would be nice here on the left side of it, right? Since it's a bicycle delivery app. Then let's go back to our list, and I'll inform that on the left, it will have a new component. This component will be of the icon button type. So let's add the icon button. That icon button will be a bicycle, and that icon will have a size of 30. I'll close the tag, save it, and let's see how it looks. Okay, we added the icon to the left side. Let's now add the right side of our component, the cancel and confirmation buttons for that delivery. So let's go back to our code. I'm going to add the property right. That property will have our new component, and this new component will be a view. Inside of this view, I have to add the buttons because, as I said earlier, the React Native code has to return only one parent component. And in this case, I'll have two buttons. So I would have two parent components if I didn't have that view. Actually, instead of left, it should be right because I'm adding to the right side. Let's add our first React Native paper button, which is the cancel button. After that, I'll add our next button, which is the confirm button. I wanted to have a colored background, so I'm going to put that its mode is contained. Let's save it and see how it looks on the screen. Okay, it looks good, but I think we have some things here to improve, like, for example, to make the color of the bicycle icon look like the application theme color, which is purple. Another thing we can do is to make these two buttons become more separated because they are very close to each other. To do that, we go to our style file and let's create a new property that will be called icon. This icon will have the color of our theme, which is our primary color. I also add a margin to the top of it because we could see that it was not centralized. I'll save it and now let's add this style to our icon. I'm going to put the style equal to homestyle.icon. And I also have to inform that its color is equal to homestyle.icon.color, as the color is not defined in the style. I'll save it and let's see how it looks. Okay, the icon is purple. Let's add the margin to our button. To do this, I'm going to add a new property called cancelButton, and I'll inform that it has a lower margin of 10. Now I have to add this to our cancelButton style. I'll inform that its style is equal to homestyle.cancelButton. I'll save it, and now let's see how it turned out. Now it looks the way I want. But what is missing on this screen are the markers showing the origin and destination of our delivery. To do that, I come to the code on the part of the map, and what I'm going to do is to copy and paste this part here just to save some time. So I'm going to change the state from 1 to 2, and I'm going to leave only two markers. One would be the origin, and the other one would be the destination. To do this, I will change here the text to origin and destination. What I will do is also to remove the bicycle icons because now they are no longer delivery persons, right? Just markers. I'll save it and now let's see how it looks on our emulator. Good, both points are here, the origin and the destination, very close to each other. So we have a very lazy person who created this delivery, right? Well, now let's create the third state of our application, which is only a screen showing that the search for a delivery person is being made. We will also have a cancel button in case the user changes its mind. To begin, I will change the state of the home screen to 3. After this, we see that nothing else on the map is visible. At the bottom part of our code, let's create a ternary verifying that if the state is equal to 3, we return for now a view. If not, we will return null. Then let's think about this third state. What's happening is that the application is looking for a delivery person to make that delivery. So what I'm going to show is a loading icon on the screen. If you go to the React Native paper page, we'll find this component called an activity indicator, which is exactly what we need. So let's use this activity indicator component on our screen. I'll inform that it is always animating. I will close the tag and let's see how it looks on our application. All right, it's being shown down there. We'll now add a title to our state, and in this title, we inform that we are looking for a delivery person in this region. Let's remember that another thing I also want to add is a cancel button. So I'm going to create a button here informing that it has a contained mode. I'll inform that its text is cancel. Okay, let's save it and see how our app looks. You can see that this is what we want, but it doesn't look that nice actually. So what we have to do now is to create a style for this part of the code. The first thing I want to do is to make that lower part of the screen to occupy half of the screen. To do this, I'll inform that our view also has the style of homestyle.flex. I'll save it and then we can see how it turned out. What I want to do now is make those three components to stay in the middle of the view. For this, we go to our home style. I will create a new attribute called flex center column. That attribute will be shown with the flex type. I'll justify its content to the center. I'll also align the items to the center. I'll inform that it will have the size of flex 1, and I'll inform that its flex direction is in column. If not, it would align the components horizontally, not vertically. Now let's save it and add that to our screen. Instead of flex, I'll put flex center column and let's see how it looks now. Well, much better, but only you can still improve this by placing the loading icon on the theme color, using the purple color. To do that, we can just copy this part of the code here and paste it into our activity indicator. I'll save it and it's purple. We will also create a space in this text here because everything is very close. So I'm going to our style and I'm going to create a new property called title. This property will have a margin of 20. I'm going to put the top margin of it as 40. I'll also align the text to the center and I'll inform that its color will also be the color of our theme. I'll save it and let's add that to our title. Style equal to homestyle.title. Let's see how it looks now. It's much better, but another thing that I want to change is this button. I want it on the bottom part of the page and to occupy almost all the length of the screen. To do this, I go to the style file and I'll create a new property, cancel delivery button. This property is going to have the attribute position as absolute. I'll inform that it will have a 2% margin, that it will be at the bottom of the screen, and that the width of it is going to be 96%. I'm going to save it now, and let's add this to our button. I'll inform that its style is the homestyle.cancelDelivery button that we just created. When you go to the emulator, we can see that now it looks much better. So let's now go through all the states that we created. If I put the state as 1, we'll see the map with the delivery persons and the button. Let's say I clicked that add button, selected the origin and destination on another screen that we'll create in one of the next videos. Then we come to the state number 2, which is the state that shows the delivery summary and the price. I can cancel or I can confirm that delivery. Let's imagine that I confirmed, we'll go to the state number 3, and alright, we have some kind of flow on our app. And for now, I have only one thing to criticize here. I think this code is too big. One thing that we can do to reduce the size of that file is to create components. In this case, I can identify at least 2 components, one being this part of the state 2, and the other one being this part of the state 3. And we will create these components on our next video. So if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if for some reason you're still not subscribed, and see you on the next video.